Hello, welcome back. Today we are going on to a new random talk, which is about how attractive are you? Having some kind of reality check, yes. Because we are living in a day of social media where reality and virtual don't really match. People are becoming more and more expert around faking it on social media, where actually what is actually happening in real life just doesn't match. And so we are having this, we as human beings have a tendency already to compare ourselves to other people because we want to fit in, we want to maximize our potential, also maximize our reproductive ability. We want to be as attractive as possible in order to get with the most attractive person that we want. And this go hand in hand with for both men and women. A woman and a man want to get with the most attractive partner they can be. The issue with social media is the standard that now it's put on all of us is the highest standard we can have. Because, and I would even argue, it's an unrealistic standard. Because even if a person is extremely attractive, they have mastered the skill in order to make them look even more attractive on social media, and so they get more followers and so on. So we arrive at a point where people, you, me, and everyone else, are comparing ourselves to those people that actually don't exist. And so, any kind of insecurity you can have will get throw you back at your face on social media. And you will start thinking, oh, I'm not good enough, oh, that I'm not this, I'm not that, and so on. So this will increase your insecurity. You will feel worse and worse about yourself, and so on. And as I said, this is not some man or woman. Both of us, both men and women, are suffering from that. So, and there is another aspect also to that. Sorry, I lost my thought of change. So yes, there is those insecurities and so on. And but on the other side, people kind of know it. They kind of knowing it. And so you have some people that are kind of delusional. Where with the feminist movement and so on, because they don't relate to the person they are seeing on social media, which of course they can't because they are not realistic people, they start thinking, you know what, I'm just awesome, I'm just fucking awesome, I don't care. And that's not true, because if that were true, they would just accept who they are and just don't talk about it. But the fact that this is a movement, fat acceptance and so on, all those things, the fact that this is the movement that is going on means that they care about what other people think, and they want to think that how they look is the good way of looking. And so this creates a delusion, because you have those women that, or those men also, that think actually they are higher values than they actually are, and they are not able to face the reality. And this is an issue, because if you can't face the reality, you cannot improve in order to get better and to live the life to the fullest of your potential. And if you live in an illusion, you won't be able to enjoy life as much as you want, as much as you can, actually. So this is a really big, big deal. And then there is another negative aspect. It sets unrealistic expectation for what an attractive person is. So me as a man, when I see all those beautiful women, those unrealistic beautiful women, when I go and meet some other women, I'm kind of disappointed. But that's not because they are ugly. It's just that my expectation is completely wrong. My standards are completely out of the window. And for women, this is the same. They see the nicest guys. They see the guys that are highly fit, muscular, tall, and so on. Those guys are spending all their life working to get this body. This is not what an average man can do. This is not what 90% of men can do. This is unrealistic. And so even women, also women, as men, we have unrealistic expectation. And so when we are going to meet men and women, when we are dating, we generally feel disappointed because we have this high standard of what a man should look like, what a woman should look like, and so on. So that's why a reality check is really important. Actually understanding what an average man look like, what an average woman look like, what you stand against this average, so you know then, okay, this is the kind of man I can attract, this is the kind of woman I can attract, and you need to accept this fact. And the reality might be not as great as you thought, or it may be greater than you thought. If you are delusional, as I said earlier, yeah, the reality might be tougher than you thought. But for the other people that generally feel more insecure due to social media, maybe the reality will feel much better than you thought. And that can help you. But the fact is, if you don't know the truth, if you don't know what the reality is actually, you can't take effective decision in order to live your life to the fullest of your potential. And so what make me thought about this subject actually today is I found a website which is called Photo Filler, where you upload your photo and people are rating you. And I thought, that's nice. That's a nice reality check, actually. So give it a try. And maybe there is also other website. I did not really make some much more research than that, but I have put the link in the description. But yeah, that's very interesting because there is two things. The fact that you will need to vote in order to get people to vote for you. And so you will be able to see, okay, what an ugly, if you're a woman, what an ugly man look like and what a beautiful man you look like. And so you will be able to have this spectrum, to have a very reality understanding of what, of the different men that, the different kind of men that are available. And for you as a man also, you will see, okay, this woman is not attractive, this woman is attractive, and you will start having an awareness, building an awareness of this spectrum. And I think, even though you can say all you want that rating people on a scale from 1 to 10, from 0 to 10 is awful, is shallow, and so on, but it's important for you to actually understand where people stand and where you stand against the vast majority of people. Once you're doing that and you start having some honest feedback about how you look, you will be able to, as I said, understand where you stand. So given that, okay, this is where I stand. I'm above average, I'm below average, I'm extremely above average, I'm extremely below average. So depending on that, this might be a relief or a curse. As I said, it's depending or not if you were delusional about your how you look, or if you were more on comparing yourself and having insecurities about yourself. And generally speaking, it comes down to having body dysmorphia, where you see yourself more ugly than you actually are. And women, especially women, tend to have that, where they see themselves much more fat, much more ugly than they actually are. So that could be also beneficial. And so then you see, okay, this is how people are perceiving me. And you will have two choices: either just accept it the way it is, and so then you will adjust your expectation based on that, or trying to look better. Unless you have tried everything in order to look better already, and just you have maxed out your attractiveness. If you didn't do that, you still have some room for improvement. And also, what I like about this website is people can give you feedback. And so, personally, I try to give very honest feedback and even some advice if those people want. But I don't know what other people are doing. But yeah, generally speaking, you can improve. You can improve where you stand. And maybe, let's say, people are rating you at 5. You are average. Okay, fine. You are average. So, first of all, what you need to understand is they are rating you based on your photo. And the quality of your photo will determine massively how much they are going to find you attractive or not. And then this is how you look inside this photo, how you present yourself, how you know how to smile and so on. And so you can start making tests for yourself. Okay, so this photo, I'm getting this kind of rating. Fine. Now I'm going to do another photo where I present myself a little bit better, a little bit deep, or even different. Or you can experiment with some photos that are actually more provocative. For a man, you can take your shirt off and just show your muscle, or the lack of you don't have. For a woman, you can pop up your boobs a little bit more. You can try or do the opposite. A very conservative outfit, very serious face, and so on. You test and you see how people respond to that. To have this reality check and also understand that generally speaking, unless you have practiced to look good on photo, if it's the first time that you are just doing photos and you have never really tried to look good on photos, you generally look worse than what you actually look like in reality. This is an art, actually, to look better on photos than what you look like on reality. And this is an art that can be learned. And this website make it much more easy because you can test. Okay, I did this photo. This photo look like this, and people are rating me like that. Fine. Now I'm testing and doing to see how can I put myself in my best self. And so if then you go on dating apps and so on, you will be able to max out the result of your dating ability, let's say. And then also you will understand your look. Okay, maybe I can do better and so on. And so in the real life, you will be able to learn how to look better. And that's why the reality check is not something that you should take bad. See, it just means this is where you stand now, but it doesn't mean you can't improve. This actually means the opposite. You can improve. You can become better. And actually, from all the women I rated, I don't think I have even one woman that I thought she can do better. Unless the very most attractive girl that nailed it with their photo, those one I didn't know what to say because they nailed it. But any more less attractive women that I saw and so on, I thought they just have a ton of things that they could do to just look Yes, I mean 2 or 3 points higher in terms of attraction. So don't be afraid of this reality check. It just means this is where you stand now, but you can improve. You can get better. So that's the first thing. And then we have having realistic expectation. By reaching people, you will see, okay, this is, first of all, you will understand where you stand on a scale from one to 10. And so if you know you if for some reason you are a 5, girl or woman, understand that looking for a person of the opposite sex that is a 7, an 8, or even a 9 is unrealistic. I mean, I hope that makes sense. And we come back to the point I made just before that this is just where you stand now. But if you improve your look, maybe you can go from a 5 to a 6 or 7. But still, if you are looking for 8 or 9, this is still unrealistic. I mean, we need to be honest about ourselves, and we will live a life well better. Because let's take both example. For a man to go look for a woman that is an 8, when let's say he's a 6, because people told me that I'm a 6 apparently. So let's take my example. For myself, I'm a 6. Looking for girls that are 8 or 9, it's just completely unrealistic. I said maybe I can get this girl. Maybe I can get this girl, but the probability that she will leave me or she will cheat on me and so on is high, because there is a lot of guys that are just more attractive than I am. Just a fact. Then maybe I can compensate with a very good personality and so on, but I need to accept the fact that I'm putting myself at risk of having a very bad relationship by targeting very attractive women that are 2 or 3 points above what I am. And on the opposite side, you have you as a woman, let's say you are also a 6, and you want a guy that is a 8 or a 9. You are taking the risk that this guy is going to cheat on you, that maybe he's going to have sex with you because you want him, and this guy have a lot of options. And so because this guy have a lot of options, because if you are looking for him, most women also tend to go look for him. And so this is not the kind of guy that you can have a serious relationship with. You may find this rare guy and so on, but also this is the same as for a man with a woman. He can have any woman he want. So are you willing to take the risk of being cheated on or on being just not being seen as a real human being? I mean, you can do it, that's fine, and maybe you will find a guy that a guy or even a woman if you're a guy that and this may work out, but that's a lot of risk that you are taking. So setting realistic expectation. I'm a 6. Okay, I'm going to look for a woman that is a 6 or even a 5 if I want. And I know if she's interested in me, she would be, generally very interested in me. She would have a genuine desire to be with me and to have a serious relationship with me. And so this changes everything. And this is the same for women. If you're targeting men that are on your same level as you are, you will maximize the chance of having your relationship go well. Then there is other aspect about relationship, but let's keep it simple about it currently. Just knowing where we stand and having realistic expectations, so we can start living the lives that we can actually live. Sorry. So we can start living the life we can actually live, and not the life that we wish we could live. I hope that makes sense. Yes, and as I say, there are other aspects that come with attraction and so on. The fact that women tend to have an attraction floor and they don't want to date lower than their own value, and men can date lower, but generally speaking, they will have sex with women that are lower values than they are, but generally they will date and marry women that are at the same level as they are. Where women won't date guys that are lower on lower values than they are, and generally want the guys that are above them. And so this is all of these dynamics that is complicated. But anyway, I'm going to do a video about femininity where I'm going to go way more deep into that. If you are a woman, you may want to come back and check it when I do it. But yeah, realistic expectation, so you can live the life you can actually live, and not the life you wish you could live. And this will make just all the difference in your happiness and long-term health, mental health, and so on. We have only one life. Let's not fuck things up. Let's not be delusional about what we can actually do, and go do the thing we can do. And enjoy life to the fullest of our potential. So, thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.